Now, John Stamos charmed a generation as Uncle Jesse in the sitcom Full House and currently stars as an intense basketball coach in the series Big Shot. Earlier this year, his co-star and longtime friend Bob Saget passed away suddenly, and John has opened up to Tracy Smith from CBS about the impact of Bob's death.
Let's start with a big question. Why not? Do you feel like you're having a moment?
I hope I am. But then if you have a moment, then that moment has to end, right, or something. I'm happier than I've ever been. You want me to clap?
If John Stamos is happier these days, this could be a reason why.
You know, if you would have just kept your lips off me, we wouldn't be in this predicament.
He's about to start the second season of the Disney Plus series Big Shot, about a hot-headed college basketball coach who gets fired and ends up coaching a high school girls' team with a certain intensity.
You know, it doesn't upset me that we stink. Actually, it does. But what gets me are the mental mistakes, because that means lack of focus, which means lack of commitment, and that...
Is it difficult for you to play a hard ass?
No.
No?
That comes
why not?
Pretty easy. I don't know why.
Truth is, John Stamos might be one of the nicest people alive, even if he's not, by his own admission, much of a sports guy.
Oh, no. I mean, it's the jacket.
It's totally the jacket.
But he is someone who seems to be hitting his stride.
Success is a peace of mind.
On screen and off.
What's happening?
In the past four decades, John Stamos has become something of a fixture in our lives. He's the heartthrob who won't ever break your heart, the friend who won't ever let you down.
Put on a happy face.
And from here to Broadway, someone who's been called one of the truly underrated actors in the game. These days, he's also a husband and a father. He married actor and model Caitlin McHugh in 2018, just before the birth of their son, Billy. It was the end of what he says was maybe one of the longest childhoods in history.
I went to becoming an adult, kicking and screaming. And when you have the whole world going, you look 20 and you're then. I didn't have any of those tent poles that say you're an adult. I was just skating through.
You didn't have to grow up.
I didn't have to. I had Peter Pan syndrome, which is dangerous, you know.
The boy who didn't want to grow up was born in Orange County, California in 1963. John Stamos was the first of Bill and Loretta Stamos's three children, and even as a kid, little John seemed destined for the stage.
And did you dream of being a star?
I wanted to be famous. I wanted to be famous so bad. And then once I got it, I loved it. I still do. You know, these people go, oh, I hate being famous. I hate taking pictures. If you see me somewhere, ask for a picture. I'm happy to do it because it's what I wanted my whole life.
Every time I turn around, you're yelling at me. Now, if that's how it's going to be, I'm back out on the streets.
He skipped college to try his hand at acting and landed a role as Blackie Parrish on the long-running soap General Hospital. But his star really took off in 1987. When he was cast as Uncle Jesse Katsopoulos in the TV series Full House.
Hey, look alive! Uncle Jesse's here!
So Full House.
Full House comes along. I'm not gonna lie, it was very difficult, a lot of it was.
Why?
Because it just wasn't where I saw myself. I mean, the reviews were like, this show won't last till Thanksgiving.
Gently now, okay. Gently, there we go. This is great. We should be mothers.
Oh, yeah.
And now I'm so proud of it. Now I'm really happy that I did that show. I'm glad I did it, obviously.
Whatever his feelings about Full House, it made John Stamos a next-level star and gave him a best friend in co-star Bob Saget. This was Saget's toast at his friend's 50th birthday bash.
You deserve so much happiness, and you are so full of love, and you are such a great person, and the talent and the looks everybody resents, but you are just, you're just a heart, and I just love you very, very much.
The two were practically inseparable, and when Saget died this past January after a fall in a Florida hotel room, Stamos was shattered.
I don't know what else to say about it other than, obviously, you know, I met one of the biggest influences in my life was Bob. I wouldn't be who I am without Bob. My parents, that's obvious, but him, you know, he was there for everything, all the good, all the bad. He was, he was my brother. You know, he's the brother that I always wanted. This is Bob's guitar that his wife gave to me.
Aww.
You can only play dirty songs on here.
John Stamos is a collector. His home is filled with photos of heroes who became friends.
The surgeon concurs with my assessment. Hey, don't worry, boss. I'm not one of those I told you so kids.
He's also collected a few screen credits, like a long-term part on the hit series ER, and more. With looks, charm, and a star on the Walk of Fame, it always seemed like Stamos had the perfect life. But there were times, he says, when he didn't always want to live it.
For the longest time when I was not sober, I was fuzzy, I thought, I've done it all. I don't want to kill myself, but I didn't care if I died.
You didn't care if you died?
I said, I've done it all. I've died. If I die tomorrow, it's okay. What was I thinking? I hadn't done it all. I still haven't done it all, not even close.
And he got something of a wake-up call in 2015 when he was arrested for driving under the influence.
You know, that fateful night of I got in my car, I thought I could drive, and I couldn't. And I just have flashes in my mind about driving in circles, and people were driving near me in the roller window, Uncle Jesse, pull over, you know, say you're driving. And then when I went to rehab, and it was the hardest thing ever. My friend said, you know, your mom was really worried about you. He said my mom would call him and say, I'm worried about Johnny. I thought I was fooling everybody. That's the thing, too. Anyway, that was that. So when that happened, I said, I can't screw this up now. I have to stay with this.
And here's something you might not know about John Stamos. He's a hell of a drummer. He's been playing with the Beach Boys and co-founder Mike Love since the 1980s.
You two have gotten close over the years. I mean, I don't mean to put you on the spot, but
he asked me to be in his wedding.
Not in my wedding. He married
officiate.
Caitlin and I.
Yeah, yeah.
You know how they say don't meet your heroes? I'm glad that I met him, because he's everything that you want Mike Love to be.
And maybe, after a few decades of figuring it out, John Stamos is everything he wants to be, too.
So what's the future look like?
I don't know. More kids, I hope.
But I'm not looking too far in advance. I'm just thinking about now.
Because the next moment might be someone, you know, gone. Right?
And this moment's pretty great.
This is a great moment. Winnie the Pooh said something like, today is my new favorite day. Making these new memories, and it's, you know, my new favorite day. Today is my new favorite day.
Ah, he likes a Winnie the Pooh quote as well.
Nice little Winnie the Pooh reference. Yeah. Fair play.